How's it going, everybody? Texas Man here. I hope you guys are all having a fabulous day. Please give this video a thumbs up if you guys really enjoy it. Subscribe if you guys have not already. Also, do me the biggest favor of all, hit the bell notification button so you guys don't miss out on future videos or streams here on my channel. Also, if you guys would head over to Twitch, follow me there at Douglas447. I stream there at least once a week, whether it's Call of Duty, Battlefield, Halo, Destiny, or anything else you guys suggest for me to watch and review over there. And in this video, we're going to be talking about positives and negatives, talking about the movie Poseidon from 2006. This movie is rated PG-13. It is about an hour and 38 minutes long. And currently, at the time of me recording this video, it is $4 to rent and $8 to buy digitally. And this was a subscriber request, so thank you guys for asking me to watch this movie and review it. If you guys have any movies you guys want me to watch and review here on the channel, drop them in the comment section on any of my videos, and I will get to watching them as soon as possible. Just make sure you put in the comment section saying, please review this movie, and I will get to doing it as soon as possible. So this is the remake of the 1972 The Poseidon Adventure, starring Kurt Russell. And this movie is about a small group of survivors trying to remain alive until help arrives on board a capsized luxury cruise ship. And if you have, you know, seen any type of disaster movie and you think of that, Poseidon basically is the updated version somewhat of Titanic. This movie has some great visuals. It is a very good disaster movie storyline wise, but not character wise. And I'll talk about that in just a second with the negatives. There are some good action sequences, and this movie is very suspenseful. Unfortunately, this movie has a lot of negative issues that I have to address, and there's a lot that I'm not going to be able to get into this video, because this video would be like an hour long. So first of all, 90% of the characters are complete idiots. Even the child character that is in this movie is stupid. The characters are constantly making dumb decisions. And it's mostly due to the writing for this movie. It feels like it's been done by a third grader, where they're like, well, okay, we'll have a disaster movie of the fact that all these people are in a ship that is upside down and filling up with water, and they are constantly making decisions, they're constantly making choices to up the stakes of this disaster movie for our characters, and it's unwarranted. Like, they're already in danger, constantly making them have to make decisions to worsen the problems that they're in is not good writing. Like, one or two problems is enough. Having more than that is overkill. The writing could have been done by anyone better. I could have done this in my sleep and made the writing for this movie so much better. Except for Kurt Russell, I felt like all of the other actors in this movie were very average or below average. Like, everyone was just there to get a paycheck. Everyone was there to fill a certain stereotypical role, and that was about it. And also, this movie is a character disaster survival film, yet I didn't care who lives or dies. I didn't care who were the survivors at the end of the movie. I didn't care. I just wanted the movie to end because I was bored. This is a disaster character movie, and although the disaster part element was cool for the first, like, 15-20 minutes, eventually that wore off, and then you're left with all these characters that are making dumb decisions and you don't care about them. So at that point, you have a very boring, please end this movie already type of film. This movie, honestly, guys, is very average to most viewers. I would say at least watch it once and then after that move on. It is good for background noise and to have as entertainment if you're bored. But honestly, if you want, go watch other disaster movies. For example, The Finest Hours or Cloverfield. With that, guys, I have to give Poseidon from 2006 a 5 out of 10. Thank you guys so much for watching. You guys have a great one.